For many of you, you might be considering whether you should use KDSPY. KDSPY might be something you've actually never heard of before, but those that have, I'm going to actually go through or run through a number of different key features that have allowed me to be able to scale my self-publishing using that software, but it also allows me to use it in conjunction with other softwares that I have as well. Now, there's plenty of features that you may not be aware about that KDSPY can offer. So this video and tutorial will be about helping you through that process. Hi, my name's Romney, and thank you very much for joining me on my YouTube channel. If you haven't been to the channel before, it's all about creating, building, and scaling your self-publishing business. Now, I've created over 350 books for KDP, and I've also created a new low and no content publishing course. So if you're interested in that, make sure you check out the description below, and you'll be able to look into seeing whether that's actually something that can help you to accelerate your self-publishing as well. So as I mentioned in the introduction, we're going to jump onto KDSPY now. I'll give you a few different scenarios of how you can use it and make sure that you're actually using it in the way it's intended to, so you can get the most out of the software. So let me jump onto my computer now. So what I wanted to do for this lesson is to go through KDSPY. Now, if you haven't heard about KDSPY before, it's a software that you can use for a whole lot of different features, including keyword research, and you can use it to track different books. You can look at helping you with different categories, sales ranks, monthly performance. There's a lot of different features that people may actually not realize that KDSPY provides. Now, it's a one-off lifetime payment that you make with KDSPY, and I'll provide the link in the description below in regards to KDSPY and if it was going to be suitable for you. So let's jump into KDSPY. Once you've downloaded it, you then can use, we'll just get rid of this, you can then go and you can download it, and you get a little Chrome extension, and that's what we're going to be using in this. So let's jump into it now. So there are two ways you can get into KDSPY. Once you've got the Chrome extension, if you were just to click on it, it would take you directly to the US bestsellers, and where currently it will default through to the books, and you then get to use what you want for all of this information here. And you can use KDSPY in a lot of different ways. So you can use it just for keywords, or you can use it under categories. So let's have a look at how it would work under categories. So if we go down here, let's just go teens, and let's just choose personal health, and we can keep going down. We can go to self-esteem, and you can keep going down even further if you wanted to, personal hygiene, and that's as far down as we can go. So what we do, we can look at all the different books in this different category. So what we do, we click on KDSPY, it would start to generate all the information that we need. And so it starts to generate the average sales rank for this different area. And you can actually see all these different books that are going on just here. So that's under all. If we were to go under books, you can select down the bottom here what you would like to look at. Now, I think what we might do, we might actually go to more of a low and no content niche. So let's get out of here. Let's go back into teens. Let's go to hobbies and games. And let's go to games and activities. And let's go to puzzles, because this might actually bring us into more areas that we can use for low and no content publishing. And what we can do is, once you have a look here, you can look down all the books. So now let's use KDSPY game to find out what information this can bring and if it can actually help us find a book or even a niche that we might be able to get into. So this will give us the all results. It's got one Kindle result and all the books. So we can click on books here. So let's have a look here. It's got the bestsellers under this category. And on the top line here, we can go to what we call our word cloud. Now, the word cloud will help us with different keywords, and these are the most popular words across the titles that it's showing the top 50 out of 144 possible words. So we can see down here, it's got the top five words used in bestseller titles, puzzle, word, puzzles, adults, and fill. And if we wanted to get more of those words, what we do, we go export, and then this will actually bring up a document which we can actually see all the different words and how popular they are. So that is a very good way of using main keywords that are appearing in titles in your titles or your subtitles. So that's another way you can actually utilize it. But if we go back to our information here, you can also do tracking for different books. So just say there we were, let's have a look at a book that's doing quite well. Well, that is doing very, very well. We can have a quick look at this one. So you can also tick off books. So if you wanted to find out the average sales rank, what we tend to do is find out any books that are outliners that are really just miles out. And this actually shows you the average sales rank, the average sales revenue, and the average price as well. Now let's look at the features. So the T is a tracking device. So if we were to push T, we can actually look at the book and we can actually find out some different information about this book. So if we want to track this book, and we've spotted it before, and we'd like to find out how it's actually tracking, then what we do, we track it, and currently down here, it's got day one. So right now, it's sitting at 4,233, and the price is estimated monthly sales, and estimated monthly revenue, so it's doing very, very well. And this will actually track it for the next 30 days. And if I come back again, it will start to show the pattern of behavior. So it's a really good way of doing that. Now, if you also wanted to, you can do a cover search of this book. So if you wanted to look where else is this cover appearing, it will take you through to Google and it will show you all the different places this book might be appearing. And this is a good way of sort of finding out it's on Amazon, yeah, so it's across those areas as well. If we were to go back again, and we'll click on this one. So that's actually the tracker, so you can do that. So now currently, if I just clicked on another book before, just to find out how we could track the ranking of a book. So if we were to go on here, if we were to say, look at 30 Days of Creativity, I just clicked that before, and we can actually view it. So this would be a viewing platform for it. And then we can actually also go back and check. We can disable it, remove it. And that's going to now allow me, when I check out the tracking system, how these books are actually going. So let's go back here again. This one here is actually a search on Google. And it will actually bring up all the different places where this book might be. So it's on eBay, it's on Book Depository, Used World of Books. Not sure if you'd want a used book from the loo, but you can actually see all the places this is going. Goodreads, Bookshop. So there's a lot of different places this book's appearing. So if you wanted to check more into where these books are appearing, that's a great way of doing it. So we go back here again. Sorry. And the last thing is the C as well. So it's the cover. And we just went to that cover before. We did a shortcut when we went straight to the book. So we can do a cover search, and that'll actually bring up all the images of where that book's appearing. So it's another really good feature. Now, if you wanted to, you could also, depends if you're doing Kindle books or normal books. But the other good feature is you can actually change the region too. So if you want to look under books in the UK, you can do that, in Australia. So it gives you all the different regions that you can actually go to. The other thing it can do is pull results from, so at the moment, it's getting results from 1 to 20, and that will give us the average sales rank. If we wanted to get results to 40, then that will actually pull the results and might give us a little bit more of an idea of how the books are tracking. And you can go down and you can tick off any that you don't want. And the other thing is you also get this traffic light system here. So it says that this category is not very popular. potential is very good and the competition is very good. So it gives you a really good opportunity to look at that. And the word cloud will obviously give you more results as well if you're pulling more words from that too. So we go back to bestsellers there. Now let's have a look at another feature for KDSPY when we're doing our keyword research. So if we were to get back out of here, go back to books, and if we were to do, let's have a think. We'll do number book for, let's do this one. And let's have a look and see, it's got 538 results. And we know we go through this process with our niche research just to find out how it's all tracking. So if we were to go down, we can actually see these books, you know, the ranking's very high, but we can actually see some different results there. And if we were, say, to have a look at this one, that one's doing very well. So let's have a look how KDSPY could work for us using this as a keyword. So we click on KDSPY up here. This will bring in the results. It's very, very high. So let's have a look and see what the issue might be. We've got some of these books here that the ranking is very, very high. So what we can do, we actually can use this feature where we can click it out. And these are the books that we really will give us a more of an indication of what it's doing. So sales rank is just under 300,000. Good average monthly revenue, average price and reviews. And if we wanted to have a look, the popularity is good, potential is good, competition is not too bad as well. And we can actually start to have a look through here. So let's look at, let's have a look at a book. This one just here. So it's only got 25 reviews. It's earning really good monthly income. Price is quite high for the number of pages. So that's actually interesting as well. Given that's 120 pages at 525, that's 111 pages at 1448. So we might want to have a little bit more of a look into this. So we click just there on the book title, and this will actually bring us up some information. So this was released on the 16th September 2021, and $14.88. Actually, we might be in the wrong region. Let me just change this. My apologies, I had it in the wrong region. That's the better. Let's just have a look at how this book's been going. So this will bring up the information about. So let's track it as well. And it's got a really good sales rank. And it's got all the information. If we go back, we'll go back in a moment and have a look. But we go down and we can check out all the information. So it's the different categories that's sitting in. It's got different review images, and then it's got the review information as well. So that's really important to sort of check out. So if we go back to KDSPY, let's go back to what we're in. And that's let's go back to books under that category. And we can scroll down and we can have a little bit more of a look and see if any of these books are catching our eye. And we'll just remember the title name. So we keep going down. This one here. So got quite a few reviews, but it's going well. So this is Dot Markers Activity Book. So if we go here as well, and we go Dot Markers Activity Book, there's a few of them, but we're looking for this one at 8132. So it's probably on the next page. So we can go next results. Once it loads. Just waiting for it to come through. And here's the book right here. So that will actually bring us all information that is contained just here for 8132. And if we wanted to have a look at that, so it's tracking it, we can do a search as well on Google and find out where this book is actually, if it's coming up anywhere, any information about it all. There's quite a few different things that are coming up because it's quite a popular keyword as well. So we can go back to here as well. And we can scroll down and have a look at any other books that might be standing out. And that's another great feature of being able to use KDP or the Amazon platform alongside KDSPY. And we can go down here and we can check out all the information about it and pull more results that will actually help us to determine whether it's a book that we want to or it's a niche that we want to get into, whether it's got much potential, and the competition's what we want as well. So remember to use different the different categories along here as well. So this one, it's got the keyword results. This one's got the keyword analysis. So it's different from when we're looking at categories. When we're looking at a keyword, it'll bring up this keyword analysis, and we can actually find out whether the keyword is in the title. So that book we're just looking at, pages of 52, keyword in the title, no, keyword in description, no. And then it's got the rating or the ranking, reviews, and the sales rank. We can go to the word cloud. That will give us all the information plus the different keywords here, and we can export it as well. And then if we want to, we can check the ranking. If we were tracking that book, we can actually view the results as well. But if we wanted to get rid of any of these books, so if we wanted to get rid of that one, we just remove it. And now we've just got those two books that we're going to be tracking for the next 30 days as well. So that's a rundown of KDSPY and the features that KDSPY offers. And it's, as I said, just another great tool that you can use to complement the other software tools that you have. And make sure you start using all the features which are available here. Remember, you can change different regions as well. It gives you the potential to go into it, and you can also look under categories or different books, also Kindle books if you're having to do Kindle books as well. And you can also use the feature to tick off any as well that may not apply or be applicable to this particular category, for example. But it's a great software, and if you're interested in getting it, make sure you check out the description on this video, and you'll see the link through to KDSPY as well. So I hope you liked that video about the key features of KDSPY and how you actually might be able to use it to scale your self-publishing. So remember, if you do like this video, to give me a thumbs up, subscribe, and hit that notification bell so you're made aware of more videos I create. And remember to check out my low and no content publishing course as well. And that should really be able to help you to scale your self-publishing. So until the next video, I look forward to seeing you then.